tip before ever changing your rear diff fluid is to check to make sure this will come out. Usually just takes a 3/8 inch wrench, just put it right in there. If you take this off, you can't get that out. You have no way to put oil in there. So we got these all hand tight, let it sit for an hour, then we'll come back and tighten them the rest of the way. It's 25 to 35 foot-pounds, I believe, or 20 to 30 foot-pounds. And I'm just going to go to 30 foot-pounds with a torque wrench and tighten these up the rest of the way. After an hour. Alright, so we got 3 quarts of 90 weight gear oil. From what I read online, I'll be using 2.5 to 2.75 or something like that. Since I know I'll be emptying at least 2, I'm going to go ahead and save these tips, or these caps, or whatever you call them. Get them off while they're clean and save them for later. These will fit on many different containers. I like to keep things like this. Set them aside for later. And we went to the auto parts store and got one of these oil hand pumps. They fit on the quarts and on also the big gallons. The big gallon jugs. Got 2 different size threads in there. Pretty nice little deal, and it's even got a lifetime warranty on it. I don't remember what it was, what the price was. I think it was around $10-ish. One thing I didn't like is the 2 tubes it came with. The longest one doesn't quite reach all the way to the bottom of these quarts. So I just cut an half-inch piece of this tube off, stuck it on the bottom so it reaches down almost to the bottom. And then we just need our 3/8-inch socket wrench. Took all 3 quarts, and it is just now coming out the hole, so that was perfect. If not a little too much, I'm trying to keep a little extra in there.